was a joyous moment at Uganda Cancer Institute today as parents celebrated the announcement by doctors that 25 children among those who have been receiving cancer treatment are now cancer-free. The children, ranging from 5 to 12 years, who survived cancer, rang the bell as they were leaving the hospital as a sign of victory over the illness. Twelve-year-old Harold Sekanjako, one of the survivors who endured chemotherapy, surgical procedure and radiotherapy to fight cancer, narrated his ordeal, what he went through during the treatment.
We started with chemotherapy, went on with chemo, but chemo didn't take my hairs. I was very fine with chemo. I was even fat when I was in chemo. I was very fat, but when I started radiotherapy, it gave me wounds in the throat, in the stomach, in the mouth. I couldn't eat.
Harold was the last in position to ring the bell for victory.
Some children were bullying me. They thought cancer was like COVID. It is an airborne disease. That's what some of them thought. But some people got it right.
The parents explained the pain they have gone through ever since their children were diagnosed with cancer.
Yafuna kemo doza zari na kwezi evili zona mtwe mzigwa.
When my child was started on chemotherapy, she lost all of her hair. It was a very painful experience. We stayed in the hospital for so long, but we are happy at last. We have won this fight. Dr. Joyce Balagade, the head of pediatric oncology services at the institute, said children are declared cancer-free only after they spend 2 years when they are off the treatment and are still well with no recurrence of the illness.
We are celebrating with our children, with our families that have been able to go through this cancer journey and emerge on the other side. We are also celebrating those who are still going through the journey.
Doctors at the Uganda Cancer Institute have reported an increase in cases of cancer among children. According to statistics, 3,000 children develop cancer annually. However, only 25% of these go for treatment, while 75% remain in the communities untreated, which puts them at risk of even death.
75% of our children that develop cancer in Uganda are not getting cancer treatment, and therefore, very, very likely that they are dying. So that is a tragedy that we are struggling, we are trying everything that we can to change that state of affairs.
The most common cancer types in children are cancers that affect the muscles, kidneys and lymph nodes. Report by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.